Rip. As soon as Sushi X walked into the studio, the stream just decided to cut off. Let's see if we can get anyone else in here. See if anyone will pull up to the studio. Oh, maybe Billy Weaver? Oh, that Billy Weaver Sushi X co-commentary. Where you at, Billy? Let's give him a cheeky call. Might just be me and you, though.
Right, sorry about that. Sorry about that. All right, I'm here. I'm here.
Sushi X just walked
The
into the studio
X
and
marks the spot.
threw a ninja star at the panel.
Yeah, I
Short
don't know what
wired everything.
happened, man. It's all the that electricity that just follows me.
I'm sure. We got that CMB.com exclusive live event coming our way. Kicking things off with some Vixens action. Oh, look at this. Jacob Ziegler's rolling in to the studio as always. Oh, this is nice now. We got Sushi X and Jacob Ziegler on that co-commentary. Oh boy.
I'm gonna try to keep it classy.
Ziegler's having some trouble putting his headset on, it seems.
I don't wanna take that fucking belt from him, before our match finally comes to fruition.
I don't think Ziggler's gonna be able to do commentary with this. He can't get this headset on. It's too small for him. As
Let's
Sushi
be honest. That's is that a That's the Anarchy Championship, right? Falls count anywhere, 24/7. I could literally call in a fucking ref right now, and we could go at it.
don't think the Anarchy Championship is 24/7.
That's always 24/7. That's what you don't understand.
We might have some more people pulling up to the studio here. I'm not sure, but Ziegler just left. He couldn't get the headset on. He just stormed out. All right,
Pretty
so
sure
this
he's
Vixens
salty that
match.
he knows I'm gonna destroy him. He's seen those matches. He's seen those last couple matches I've had. He's sweating it a little bit. He had to take his frustration out on Xander Slate last week, so he's sweating a little bit.
What do you think that was all about, by the way? Jacob Ziegler. Why do you think he attacked
Well,
Xander Slater?
I mean, in my opinion, Ziegler, he's the type of guy that doesn't take he doesn't take a fucking back row to anybody. And Xander Slate's the spotlight. And I think Ziegler was using him for as much as he could, and now he wants to be the spotlight. He doesn't like to take that back seat to anybody. So that's just my opinion. Obviously, I obviously have no clue, but that's how I
I
get
think it's
that
just
vibe
all
from
the,
Ziegler that.
I think it's just all the frustration, honestly, getting to, hang on. Tim is texting me right now. Says he's on the way to the studio. But all the frustration on top of him, he feels there's some sort of conspiracy. The corporate's not booking him, even though he's the greatest champion of all time. He is the longest reigning champion of all time. Give him that. I don't know about the greatest champ of all time. He's getting a little bit cocky. Many people backstage feel he's a little bit self-righteous. He doesn't show respect where it's due, and he came out, voiced his opinions, all of this and that. And Xander came out, just had to poke the bear with a stick, throw out those insults. And then when Ziggler was finally booked on Genesis, supposed to fight Cage, Xander said, "I pulled some strings. You go relax, and I'll take the match for you." So I think Ziggler's just saying, "Xander Slate, I don't need you to do anything for me. This was my match." And now Xander. He's got that minor concussion. Still able to compete, but we'll have to wait and see what happens with the coalition here. As we get ready for this Vixens match to kick off the live event, Kacee Wilson, who made her in-ring debut at last week's live event, defeating, or actually earlier this week at a live event, I should say, after a fusion, defeating Danielle Ward, looks to continue on with her momentum.
Yeah, I wasn't sure the CMV was actually recruiting transgenders in their Vixen matches, because that's a man, baby.
You know what? I think she's pretty attractive. I don't know what everybody's saying. And you know what? Even if she is pretty attractive, it doesn't matter. It's not about looks. That's what Casey Wilson says. It's not about looks. It's about the competition. It's about the sport.
She could pass. She could sit underneath a bridge and pass as the ogre who collects tolls.
Well, anyhow, Casey Wilson, Sushi X throwing out that fire. There's only one for him, and that's Rose Punish.
There's no one gonna be more beautiful than Rose Punish.
Casey Wilson can continue on that momentum. Actually, Aura on Genesis called out Casey Wilson, and Wilson, she says she's not talking trash, but in a way she is. She says she finds it hard to respect this division and everybody in it. They're always talking trash. They're more concerned with their looks, and she has a couple good points, but Aura felt she was disrespecting her, challenged Casey Wilson to a match, and Casey Wilson responded by saying, oh, I got some sirens outside the studio here. What's going on there? Some lights. Whoop, whoop. That's the sound of the police.
But, that's the sound of the police.
Casey Wilson saying, if Aura wants to get in the ring and have her face bashed in, she will gladly hand her a loss. But Casey Wilson says she's not talking smack. She respects Aura, saying she even likes Aura's dank attire back at the Absolution pay-per-view. But I guess we'll wait and see how that develops further. As Kayla Turner, who has been here since the start of Season 3, haven't seen her in a while, though, returning to action. The last remaining remnant of good old voodoo.
If Gargamel from the Smurfs had sex with a hippopotamus, that would be Casey. That'd be the Spawn.
Damn. You're not into Canadians, I guess.
Jesus Christ, if that's what Canadians look like, then yeah.
I mean, Randy Orton digs her. He's a big fan, I heard, backstage.
Well, Randy Orton's kind of a dirty bird, so I can understand that.
What about that back tat? I know you're a big fan, Sushi X, of back tats. You gotta like that back tack on her. That back tack. That tax is on her back, you know? Would you kiss it?
I mean, I don't even. What is it? I don't even know what it is. I can't even tell.
I actually can't tell what it is either.
Is it like two pieces of bacon fucking each other?
Turkey bacon. I don't know. I'd kiss it. I'd kiss that back tat.
Would you lick it? Would you fry it up? Would you put it in between two pieces of toast with some eggs?
Evenly matched, at least appearance wise, the same height, same build. Kayla Turner, I believe she made it to the semifinals maybe in the inaugural Vixens tournament. Again, she kind of fell from grace, was gone for a few months, returned, then left another few months because of an injury. She's back now, see if she can quell this young talent, or if Casey will prove to the Vixens roster why she's here to shake things up, in her own words, legitimize the division. Oh, nice bear hug slam there. Still to come in this live event, in the main event, it's an anticipated match between the Unholy Alliance and Extreme Conditions. I've been looking forward to it, at least. Two been exchanging words the past few weeks.
If Deadpool hate-fucked Reed Repulsor from the Power Rangers, that would be Casey. That would be the Spawn.
If a fucked-up avocado fucked another avocado, that's what Casey Wilson would look like.
No, that'd be Deadpool. And then Deadpool would fuck Reed Repulsa.
Is this not from Power Rangers?
Yes. I mean, I feel like I said
looks
that,
pretty,
but that's
she actually
right.
Looks pretty good in the new movie. I don't know if you've seen her.
No, that's because that's Elizabeth Banks. And she's always beautiful. I'd love to have her in my corner. And by corner, I mean play with my butthole. But that's a different story.
Well, what do we got here? Electric chair, roaring elbow. Now I officially despise Kayla Turner. Again, ladies and gentlemen, Purgatory just 1 week away. And along with some huge matches, we'll also finally see the anonymous general manager revealed. who he is, making all these huge announcements these past few weeks, and I'm being told he has a few more huge announcements at Purgatory when he arrives. What do you think of this new guy so far, Sushi? I think he's doing a better job than Savage or any other manager for that matter. He's only been GM for 2 weeks. I think he's doing pretty good.
Well, I saw a post on the website, and you know, I'm pretty sure they figured it was my sister, Jade. I don't know, but if you do look on the site, yeah, it has her. It has her as, oh, you know, maybe they're trying to
that botch.
Maybe they're trying to you know, push it away from who it really is. Maybe they're just trying to, you know, get that conspiracy theory going. But so far, yeah, I'm liking what he's doing. You know, he gives me, you know, I like it. But Jesus Christ, yeah, just watch the replay and.
Wait, are you trying? I want to back up for a second before you go on. Are you trying to confirm that your sister is transgender? Because you're saying him, but then you're saying it's Divine. I mean, I hope
no,
not.
I'm saying him as the as the real person behind the real GM.
Ah. Well, one way or another, we're gonna find out who it is. Sandy's gonna bring
a new era.
He's definitely
shaking it up.
Sandy's gonna bring a new era. I personally think I'm not a big fan of Cole Savage, but I personally think he's doing a better job than Savage ever did, than William Regal, JBL, Shawn Michaels ever did. And only these 2 weeks.
Well,
he's been
Cole
GM.
Savage is a fucking snake.
Ooh.
And I mean, anyone can do a better job than him, because all he does is sulk, and then just make decisions off of it. And anyone
can
be better than him. So,
I feel like
yes.
You're taking this not only because you guys have fought before, but also this whole thing he's doing with Cooper and Castlefave, and Castle, of course, the mama of your good pal, you know, Tim LaFave, ex-Gen member. How do you feel about
that? Yeah, I mean, he's definitely
that?
Disrespecting. He's definitely disrespecting my boy's mom, a fellow ex-Gen member, Cass. And obviously, I'm not all about the disrespect. And so, yeah, it's a little personal. And then, you know, obviously, the whole hardcore championship before it became the Anarchy, that still has something to play with it.
I want to get your thoughts on two things. You bring up the Anarchy Championship. We know that you will be main eventing Purgatory next week, taking on Hayden inside Hell in a Cell. Want to know what your thoughts are going to that, but also we know that following, wherever it's going to be leading up to Ascendance, you will be getting your shot at Jacob Ziegler for the Anarchy title. So hey, tell us how you feel about these things.
Well, Hayden, I mean, last I saw of Hayden, he was cut himself, and then he wants to pretend like he never left, or we were scared of him. I mean, you goddamn right we were scared of you, dude. You were cutting yourself. I mean, that's. I don't know what to say about that. But I would like to. I mean, is he right in the mind? I don't know. Maybe this Hell in a Cell will set him right in the mind, because it still seems like he's still in his old ways with that. I mean, he's probably still cutting himself, but he's keeping it on the low key.
A lot of people remember because it was kind of tucked away and it kind of went away fast. But during the whole Civil War and Hayden was trying to find out where he was, we had the rebellion which you led, and the corporation coalition wasn't around yet. But you and Hayden actually went toe-to-toe at Regicide. You guys fought one-on-one, with you actually coming out the victor. So the last time you guys went one-on-one, you did emerge. But like you said, Hell in a Cell, anything can happen. Step inside the Devil's Playground, you're going to be a changed man. And of course, you guys already have 3 years ago. First ever Survivor Series, you went one-on-one inside Hell in a Cell again, which you won. And that's why Hayden.
Yeah, but this is going to be, and to be quite honest with you, the reason why I wanted a Hell in a Cell match is quite honestly for one reason. The first time he said he laid down for me. And I want to prove to him, I want to prove to the fans, I want to prove to myself, first and foremost, that I can beat him in the Hell in a Cell.
Well, the first Hell in a Cell, you tapped him out. But yeah, you're right. Hayden likes to say he laid down for you, and it was a whole conspiracy, like a whole concoction between the both of you just to get him in action. But this time, you two have been exchanging bitter words these past few weeks. You actually went at it pretty hard at the end of last week's live event, or earlier this week, I should say, but certainly a lot of emotions flying high. How do you feel about Hayden? He keeps referring to you, and every time someone says X-Gen, he has to butt in and say X-Gen 0.5. He says he's X-Gen, that you guys left
That's
him.
just that's just his way of coping with the fact that we've moved on without him.
Well, Casey Wilson's looking
Cut
to
and dry,
finish
simple.
with that rude awakening. Gonna grab the leg and bend it in a way it shouldn't be bent. That pin animation, though. One, two, three, and Casey Wilson remains undefeated, picking up another big win.
I mean, if you were part ogre, I mean, you'd be able to pick up easy wins too.
Well, we got some fans saying that, and I've been hearing this a lot. You guys have been going back and forth on Twitter a few times these past few weeks, but Hayden has been very vocal in the ring. He's called you out a couple times, but a lot of the fans are wondering, why aren't you addressing Hayden? Why aren't you coming out and talking to him face to face? But you go on all these Twitter things. I mean, what's the deal? What's going on?
I like to let my wrestling talk for me.
Well, we know
I mean,
Hayden's
I don't know
certainly
what
not one
else.
to keep his mouth shut. He loves going on and on. He's a big talker, is the A-lister. Sushi X saying it himself, though. Gonna let his
Yeah,
actions at Purgatory speak
and
for him.
he's and the thing about Hayden is he said, "Oh, I've never attacked you personally. I didn't start the attack." But he did start the attack when he talked about X-Gen. That's us. That's family. You again, we win the belt. You win the belt, we win the belt. Everyone wins the belt.
Yeah.
You talk shit about one member of X-Gen, you talk shit about all the members of X-Gen. There's
and
no
then
fucking ifs, ands, or buts about it.
and just earlier this week on Monday Night Fusion in the main event, he had a match set with Ryan Kent. He attacked him as Kent was making his entrance. Came back to bite him in the end as it did the loss, but Hayden's clearly not a big fan. Trying to get an edge
Yeah,
over
see,
you.
and again, I choose my words wisely. I'm never gonna talk shit before a match, okay? Because I never know the outcome. I mean, he's actually a great wrestler, and he could win. I will only address the fact afterwards. Call it cowardice, call it whatever you want to. But after the fact, when Kemp pinned him, one, two, three, yes, I had to address it. I had to say something to him, let him know, like, hey, man, like, that's what you have, that's all you got. I mean, he himself has said that Kent's the weakest link. He's one of the weak guys. He's the 0.5, whatever the fuck he says. And okay, if he's the 0.5, if he's one of the non-true X-Gen members, then why did he beat you?
Indeed. Some good points made there. Nonetheless, it all comes down to what happens inside that hell in a cell at Purgatory. Oh, wait a minute, before I go on, we've got a tweet here from the man himself, Hayden. He says, "Letting your wrestling speak for yourself, but where's your singles titles?" Oh, Hayden's going deep.
Yeah, I mean that's all good. That's all good and said, but where were your singles titles? Oh, that's right, when you were next gen. Okay. Got you. That's a cool story.
I'm sure Hayden's gonna respond to that. He's not liking this. Someone went and
I'm
got
sure
him.
he will respond to it,
Someone
but
went and
he
got
can't
him.
argue it.
Hayden
He can't
talking.
argue it.
She's talking all this ish. I mean,
Well, I mean, what's he gonna
I wish
argue?
we could get the A-lister in here. Maybe he can still make it to the studio. And here's a tweet before we move on to the next match by a fan who says, "Are you using this whole Hayden situation as an excuse not to be embarrassed by Ziegler on a grander stage?"
Nah, see, the thing is, I want to win the title in a great sense, right? And there's no better sense than ascendance, right? So why not? Why not? I mean, you might not even be holding the title. He might not even be holding the title when it
Well, I
comes
haven't gotten any
to
reports
my
that he's
title match.
defending at no, he's defending against you next. You're the next challenger whenever it goes down, whether it's Ascendance or after Purgatory, we're not too sure, but
I mean, you're hearing it right here. Let's do it on the grandest stage. Let's make it big. Let's make a fucking name for ourselves. Or for myself, you know.
We'll see Crow in action,
I mean,
flanked by his soap.
just the sheer presence of me in the room. I mean, you saw him. He walked out. He came in, didn't know what to do with himself, Ziegler, that is, and then just walked out. Just the sheer presence of me just scared him away. So, I mean, what are you gonna do?
Some strong words there for Sushi X directed at Jacob Ziggler, the Anarchy Champion. That title match is good. I'm excited for it. Like I said,
I
I'm
mean,
a.
I'm sorry, I didn't want to cut you off. I'm not taking anything away from him. Great wrestler, but I mean, it's gonna be a match, a match. I mean, that's why I'm saying let's do it on the grand stage because it's gonna be we'll probably steal the pay-per-view. We'll probably steal the pay-per-view easily, because that's how I do. And I know Ziggler, he's gonna put 100% against me just because of the whole rivalry we've had with. The war that we had, the civil war that we had, the tearing, and then just the animosity that we just saw him against Xander Slate. I mean, he's stepping up.
Hang on. I got a bit in because we got a response from Hayden. Knew this was coming. He says, won two titles after you left X-Gen. One of them I didn't even want. You kept sharing half a title with your brother who carries you. That's some fire spit out by Kaitly there.
Okay, so, and I mean, okay, I get it. He says he carries me. Okay, why? Because he won a singles match? Nah. If you go back and check the tape, I'm pretty sure we're about same wins when it comes to the tag matches. I've won them and he's won them. It doesn't make sense. Why? Because he's got a singles match on me. He's got a singles belt on me. I'm not gonna buy it. Not gonna buy it. He's trying to break us up.
Sushi X not well. We know that Quantum. He could have chosen you, but he's Quantum said it himself that he wants you to focus on your singles career. He wants you to finally realize your dreams of being a single star. So he went and chose fellow X-Gen member Ryan Kent to try and grab them Tornado Tag Team title belts at Purgatory. Otherwise, I'm sure we'd see you guys, the OG X-Gen, try and tear it up and win your
Yeah,
fifth tag team title.
I'd actually like to address that because I mean, I actually brought it was just me and him. I met him in the locker room and I was like, "Look, man, this is what we got to do. I mean, I either get a single shot or we go for that coveted tornado tag, man." And he seriously was like, "Listen, brother, I want you to get this. I want you to finally get this." And I couldn't argue with him. I was like, "All right, man, if this is what you want, then this is what I'll do."
Certainly,
And
dreams will be realized not only of you, but the entire CMB universe is behind you when your fifth attempt at trying to capture the Anarchy Championship. Will you be able to defeat Jacob Ziegler, though, who is the longest reigning champ, certainly dominant, and like you said earlier, has a vicious streak in him lately. See what happened to
yeah,
poor
it's gonna
Xander.
be. I mean, I talk a lot of shit over here, but yeah, it's definitely gonna be. It's gonna be like I said. We're probably gonna steal the pay-per-view if it does happen at the pay-per-view. We'll steal it easily,
Well, we got a
easily.
response here from Hayden. He says, in every tag team, there's a Marty Jannetty and a Shawn Michaels. Quantum is not the former. Hayden's just trying to rub the salt in the wound at this point. Vintage Hayden, he tries to get his opponents riled up, but Sushi's trying to keep him out of his head. Good strategy, but I actually touched on it during your Genesis match. You're known in the past for letting your emotions get the better of you, whether it is anger or joy. And Sushi, I'm going to give you a tip right here. Don't let Hayden get in your head. Like you said earlier, just stay
No, it's
focused on the
true.
match. Like
That's
you
a true
said yourself.
statement. It is a true statement. I do let my emotions get the best of me, but I mean, let's be honest. Last Hell in a Cell match, I beat you, and then I didn't want to say shit afterwards. He said he laid down for me. I didn't know he laid down for me. If he wants to say like we had a plan, there was no plan. I beat him, and if he laid down for me, that was his own fault.
And he just laid out for you, tapped out inside that Hell in a Cell.
Yeah, which I mean, let's be honest. You get pinned, but I mean, makes you look like a bitch boy when you tap out.
John Reed already making his presence felt ringside here, so he distracts Elijah Stewart, and Elijah is set for a big battle against Duke Briggs at Purgatory in a last man standing match after Elijah accused Duke of being the one to attack his brother DJ and put DJ out of action with a torn quad and a dislocated shoulder a couple months back. See that collision? I'm looking forward to it. Only the second last man standing match this season. going to be coming away. That's a pay-per-view full of some dangerous matches. Last Man Standing, Hell in a Cell. It's going to be a pay-per-view to see as we get a nice arm drag there from Elijah. Going to go for a Dark Matter, it's looking like. What's up, Tim Rage? Another Tim! Tim 2.
Not going to lie, Purgatory looks like a... should be a great pay-per-view, to be honest with you. It's looking even bigger than the it's probably going to be like the best pay-per-view this year, to be honest. Because I mean, there's some pretty big matches going on.
We got a big tweet here from Hayden. He says, "Every dog has his day." I don't know how to pronounce that. And I feel like I'm going to be an idiot.
Lancaster City.
Is it Lancaster? Lancaster City.
I'm assuming he means Lancaster. I don't know.
Finished near the bottom last year. This year they won the Premier League. You're a one-trick puppy, and I've learned all your tricks. Damn. As John Reed tosses in a steel chair. Wait a minute. Elijah's going to try to use it. No, Crow shuts him down, uses it, bashes him in the head. I don't know this football talk, all right? Leave me alone.
Yeah, no. See, he wants to try to act like I don't watch fucking soccer. Which this is what we call it in America, so no big deal. But
well, that's gonna rub Hayden.
Yeah, no, I actually, I did actually watch the Premier League, and they had a good team. They had a solid team, which no one thought they were gonna win. You're right. But I don't know what that has to do with one on one when there was 10-on-10. So.
Well. I see some fans tweeting out here about Elijah's, the way Elijah's acting in this match. We've seen a new side of Elijah. And even before his brother was attacked, DJ said, "We got to shape up, man. If you ever have hopes of being champs again, we got to bring out the aggression." Elijah was reluctant, but we've seen him bring a new style to the ring. Some dirty heel tactics, dare I say. He just tried to use that steel chair against Crow here. But fair enough, because John Reed has already interfered about four times. The match is only going on for about 3 minutes. As Crow cranks that neck now. Purgatory, the final stop before we get on our road to Ascendance, the fourth annual Ascendance, the grandest stage of them all. We know that Kendall Wolf will be there winning the Royal Rumble match. We know that either Brian Novak or Justin Sane will be there. But will the Moo Moo Man, Randy Orton, be there? If he can beat Kendall Wolf, he will at Purgatory. Oh, now big time stomp down onto the gut. Tim, if you want to join the show, all you got to do is, well, click on that link that cop just pasted for you. Go there, register, and then just check things out, man. Post your cause name in the waiting list or the thread that says download my cause, please. You know, we got roster pages, rankings, superstar bios. You can promote your superstar if you want to, all that good stuff. Plenty of room. Nice side suplex there by Crow as John Reed keeping his distance now. Ref not ejecting him. Oh, into the these are the steel barricades, not like the Fusion and Genesis ones. It's not going to feel good. You know why I have you here, Sushi X? I want to address something real quick. It was it was last month sometime, an episode of Genesis. You attempted a splash, I believe it was, on the top rope, and you landed neck first on the ring apron. A lot of fans are wondering, what happened there? I mean, how did you not get a broken neck? Are you okay? Are you actually dead?
Listen, some may say that, but, you know, I drink my milk and I eat my Wheaties, and that's what keeps me strong.
Randy Orton will be proud as Crow goes for the pin off the Bangarang. Only gets that two count, though. Elijah's in a sticky predicament without DJ Moore in his corner to help him out to battle against these unfair odds. A read for this. Come on, ref. This is ridiculous. Why is he not being ejected, actually? Uh-oh, to the top goes the big man. We've seen Crow hit this before. He beat the likes of Hayden and Sunshine with this maneuver. Swanton Bomb right into the pin. One, two, three, and he got it. Crow defeating Elijah Stewart. Well, thanks.
That's a big guy coming down with that.
That is devastating finishing maneuver. But about 80% of that victory going to go to John Reed ringside. This referee obviously paid off here because, man, he just let those interferences roll. Nonetheless, a nice win for the Fallen, and Crow specifically, as they've kind of fallen out of the tag team. They were number one contenders at one point last month, but after being defeated by the Fast and the Furious, they were rising high, undefeated for a few weeks when they first showed up, but nice singles win.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised if they actually drift apart here, because, if that's a win, a win's a win, right? And if you're winning in singles, why go back to tag?
Fair point. Well, like I said, when Crow's about to hit his finisher, he has beaten the likes of Hayden and Sunshine before on his own. Has this big man. What a move. Someone like him with that agility off the top of Swanton. It's nasty. And of course, we still got that main event of the live event coming. Big tag action between the Unholy Alliance and Extreme Conditions. Club Pangud. I'm not reading all those tweets. Do a promo. I mean, we got this. I appreciate the tweets, but I mean, you guys are like doing a whole feud promo here in the chat right now. I'm not about that life, especially on the live event. One like equals one prayer, Tim. All right, we got the Unholy Alliance. Bill Maverick leading his new recruit, Bloody Justice, into battle. They're going to take on a childhood pals, Eric Thunder and Matt Jefferson.
You know, I would like just to point out that I remember these live shows when I was biting. You know, I was there. I was just hoping to get on that live show, and it's weird to see, you know, be on that other spectrum finally. You know, always being on the main card, and then watching these newcomers. You know, just hoping and praying to get these live shows. Not even newcomers, but you know, they're trying to get on that show. But it's weird to be on that other spectrum, the other side.
It's not every day that you get to make your debut against Bison.
Yeah. All right.
Well, fair I enough. Asked you this a couple months ago when you were on commentary with me. Is there any new guys that are rustling their tail feathers, per se, that you've taken a notice in, that you're liking, you like their work ethic? Who you got your eye on?
And I think my answer is going to be the same as last time you asked me. And I don't fucking care.
Savage. Feel like you just said you're watching these guys butt their asses off and you don't care about them.
No. I mean, I don't care about them, but at the same time, I see that side that used to be me, you know, hoping and praying to get on that match.
Not everybody can be a king of main event like the Moo Moo Man. You know what I'm saying?
And that's true. And like I tweeted last week, how I remember specifically that this goes on the live event. The Moomoo Man used to call out each member of X-Gen every live event, hoping to get on that card. And now it's different. Now he's main eventing, and you know, I'm fighting some of the biggest names in the business. So again, the tables have turned, and it.
Look at the difference a year can make here, and seeing if you're Randy Borton, last year's ascendance, defending the hardcore title against Timothy this year, he could possibly be main eventing the show of shows.
Exactly.
Borton's worked hard.
Two years ago, he was calling out X-Gen members.
That's true.
And was losing.
His first ever WrestleMania, he was involved in Money in the Bank. Just got to work your way up. And here comes the Unholy Alliance. Usually, Bill Maverick is tagged along by Daryl Richards. But this time, it's the newcomer, Bloody Justice, who's coming off a victory against Chris Andrews in a false count anywhere match a few weeks back. This guy is
big. Now, I wouldn't
say
Blade Justice is got my attention, but this kid's a psycho. So, I mean, I definitely have my eye on him, but, you know, do I care about him? Not really, but I like watching his matches because he's definitely insane.
Well, we got a tweet here from John Reed, who was just in the corner of Crow that last match. He says, "The Unholy Alliance, you ain't unholy. You don't worship the true darkness. The Dark Lord gives us strength, so we will meet. The Fallen will win. You will be forgotten. Hashtag respect no one." So the Fallen targeting the Unholy Alliance.
I've got a hashtag for them. Oh, yeah. Hashtag, who the fuck is this Dark Lord that these fucking teams are trying to wear? Yeah, I feel like it's Levi Marta and people are just, you know, fighting for his attention.
Well, Levi Marta's going to NXT. We heard from him a few weeks back. He kind of just came out of nowhere after Ken Wolf had an interview. He came up to the camera.
That's true.
He just pretty much announced he's going to NXT. So expect Levi Marta down on Unmatched and Intensity soon. That's going to be something to see. As extreme conditions make their way out here, have had a rocky start to their run as a team. Lost to Fast and Furious in their debut, and then lost in the first round matchup Tornado Tag Team Tournament earlier this week on Fusion to the Briggs family, so they can finally pick up a win here. Tag Team Division. Heating up. Certainly one of the focal points, I should say, of Season 3 is the Tag Team Division. Earlier this week, that there's even more teams that have been signed and put together that haven't debuted yet. I'm being told there will actually be a new tag team debuting next week on a Monday Night Fusion, so expect a new team to make their presence felt there. I'm excited for that. Now that we got two tag belts, you know, there's more and more teams going to be put together, including Parker.
I've been wanting to face some of these teams because, like you said, the division is out of control now. Out of control. And
I've actually...
A lot of good teams.
I was told earlier this week that there's even more teams that have been signed and put together that haven't debuted yet. I'm being told there will actually be a new tag team debuting next week on a Monday Night Fusion. So expect a new team to make their presence felt there. I'm excited for that. Now that we got two tag belts, you know, there's more and more teams going to be put together, including Parker on Fusion this week. Parker was actually looking around the whole arena. He was in the catering area, backstage in the production trucks. He was going everywhere, and eventually he came to my announce table. I was a little bit freaked out, and I asked him, "What are you doing, Parker? You're looking everywhere. You're freaking everybody out." And he said, he just showed me a picture of the bracket for the Tendo Tag Tournament, and he pointed to one of the empty things, trying to tell me he's looking for a partner. So apparently Parker wants to shackle up with somebody now, the Lunatic, after losing his shot at the Anarchy title. Although we know that the tournament is final now. X Gen get that pass to the finals.
I was going to say, I don't know why he's putting an empty bracket when...
It's crazy, isn't it?
Yeah, that's true.
He doesn't even speak. True. But X Gen got that pass to the finals, and next week on Fusion we'll find out who will be meeting them at Purgatory as the Briggs family clashes with Foreign Affairs. Oof. That nasty stomp down onto the quad. This is the main event of the live show, indeed, there, Hardline. Tagged to Matt Jefferson now, and Bloody Justice is an absolute phenom to look at. He is huge, so strong, as you can see right there. Matt Jefferson's arms flailing as he gets caught with that gut-wrench suplex, I should say. And I just bashing MJ back of his head right into the mat, trying to see that blood. Where is Joey Bacon? And Bill Maverick hasn't even been tagged in this match. Actually, I think he started off the match. He's tagged in Bloody Justice right away. Wants this monster to do his work. Certainly, Bill Maverick, his plans, Maverick just cost his partner there. That was weird. Bloody Justice is going to pay for it, but Bill Maverick's plans as of late to conquer CMV and bring his Dark Army down onto the universe and that whole amulet thing he had with Fury. Every plan, every corner is being met with resistance by the likes of Fury and Cassie Maverick and everybody trying to stop him. He says it's all part of the plan, though. All the pieces are falling into place. He's recruiting. Got Bloody Justice now, Daryl Richards, Aura, the Unholy Alliance getting bigger and bigger. I'm scared for what Maverick has planned as he hits that DDT now. On MJ nearly gets the win too. Damn. Ooh, MJ just not a little pissed off there. MJ also suffered a singles loss at Absolution to Duo Maxwell. Entered pretty late. I think it's like 20, 26 or 27 did MJ on the Rumble. I think he was in the final five maybe before he got eliminated.
Yeah, to be honest with you, old Jefferson, like I said, I had him in the fight against Duo, but he kind of went out pretty quick. I mean, he kind of lost pretty quick.
They did. Duo Maxwell bashed his brains in with a metal bat. MJ just couldn't take it anymore. As the Unholy Alliance are whipping some ass in this match, so complete domination thus far, taking it to extreme conditions. Tim, please include live event results, by the way. I forgot to tell you that last time. Live event match results, though, I'd appreciate it if you included that results from now on. It'd be nice. Please and thank you. Thank you and please, Tim. Snap suplex by Maverick now as he takes down Eric Thunder. Eric Thunder made an impressive debut here in CMV after hyping himself for months, getting a win over current or one half the tag champs now, Bob Storm. And actually, next week on Monday Night Fusion, we know that Fast and Furious will be defending those belts they won at Absolution against the former champs T and Lee, your ex-gen stablemates. What are you thinking about that match? I think T and Lee are gonna win back the belts, or think their time in the sun is done?
Nah, you never want to give them a rematch because they are gonna come back even more determined than before. So yeah, they're gonna win it easily.
Oh, easily. Sushi X, you heard it here saying T and Lee are gonna walk over Fast and Furious. Well, I don't know about the Absolution. I don't know what's going on with Blade Justice here. He's just dragging Eric Thunder around the ring, trying to make a tag, I think, for a tag team maneuver. He's having some trouble with it, though. Once again, he's going to. Oh, no, there goes the tag to Bill. Gets into the ring. Now we got that double Russian leg sweep. But I brought it up on Genesis. What would it mean for you to have T and Lee as world tag champs, Ryan Kent and Quantum, Tornado tag champs, and then you as Anarchy champ? You'd just be reigning in that gold, that cheddar. That would be something to see. Exchange and gold.
Yeah, I'm a big cheese fan, so cheddar is definitely in my DNA, and that would be very nice.
All right, Tim, I'll check him out after the show, my friend. It'll probably be downloaded pretty quick. While you're there, try to
I
stay
would just
active on
like
the.
to,
Go on.
just like to point out, I didn't know if you noticed me hobbling in here, but I did irritate a previous injury, ACL surgery I had before I joined CMB, so hopefully it doesn't keep me down for anything. You know,
Did
not
you
trying to make
aggravate
any
that in the
excuses,
Novak
but
match? That was a pretty
it was aggravated
hellacious bout.
just a tad. I caught my knee wrong coming off that springboard, and then he caught me with
Oh, wait a
the
minute.
Novocaine, which
Extreme combination by extreme conditions, a twist of fate, and then a swanton bomb. One, two. Oh, just a two count, though. Before we get into more of that injury, I just want to tell Tim here, try to stay active on the website. You don't have to. It's not necessary for you to stay active on the website. Being active at the streams isn't a must either. You can watch them playback, but you know, just try to show us that you're still watching from time to time. And on the website, if you want a promo, you can. There's a section, roster page, check things out. As extreme conditions, we're so close to getting the win there. But Bloody Justice somehow fighting out of that nice combo.
Yeah, I don't know how he even kicked out of that. That's
Oh, but
just
wait a minute.
Sheer determination.
Air raid siren by MJ. We actually saw you hit that multiple times in your match against Novak on Genesis there. Will it be enough to keep down Bloody Justice? No, it will not. This man is resilient as hell as Eric Thunder once again beating down Bill Maverick. So we just heard it from Sushi X aggravating his ACL there in the match against Novak. See if that becomes a target for Hayden at Purgatory. Shouldn't have said that, to be honest. Because now I think Hayden's licking his lips.
I mean, it's. Yeah, let's be honest. It's. I mean, the doctors are going to release it anyway.
Oh,
they
wait a minute.
Have
Here
to,
goes.
So he would have found out.
A second extreme combination, the way it's supposed to be hit. Twist of fate from MJ and then a swanton from Eric Thunder. And if MJ can stop fear, this one's over. One, two. three, and what a comeback for extreme conditions, being dominated there, but hitting two extreme combination tag fins on Bloody Justice to get themselves their first victory as a tag team.
And just to correct you from earlier, there was a fan that actually corrected you himself, saying, "And if Jade gets that that Vixen
title,
oh
yeah, that's true.
We'll have a lot of gold."
Jade Divine at Ascendance, I should say, the co-main event on the grandest stage of them all, the cheeky Japanese girl. But who will she battle?
And to be,
will it be Quinn Bell or Fury?
To be honest with you, it brings a tear to my eye just to, you know, I've never even reached those heights yet, in her.
Your little
her
sister.
First year in, and she's already, yeah. I'm proud.
Let's not take anything away from you. I mean, one of the most impressive performances, the second annual Ascendance, you and Quantum defeated three other teams in that turmoil to retain your title.
Oh, we've definitely had our accolades, but again, like I said, just to have, you know, the little sister coming in and making a name for herself and actually doing well for herself brings a tear to the eye.
And Jamari, you're on that Tim business, my friend. My beautiful call maker. Make that call for Timmy. Timmy 2. Big victory for Extreme Rules. Their first win as a duo, taking down the Unholy Alliance, throwing yet another wrench in the plans of Bill Maverick. Nothing going the Unholy One's way lately. Nice win for these guys here, though, in the main event of this live event. Now, I'm asking you more. He just said he wants me to make the call, but I'm not going to make him calls. So just go see what he put down on the site, my friend, and whip it up for me, if you will. Preach. Preach, as Tim would say. But thank you guys for joining me. As always, if you like what you saw and you want to see more, I stream every Monday. Sorry, my fucking throat. Every Monday and Friday, so the next episode is Friday, the Go Home Show Fusion. Just 2 weeks away from Purgatory. 1 week away, I should say, from Purgatory. And then we begin Ascent to Ascendance. We continue down the road to Ascendance, the grandest stage of them all. All the past episodes of CMV are on my YouTube channel, linked on my Twitch page, as is a link to the website. If you want your call on the show, just check that out. And I will see you guys next time. Oh, wait a minute. First, I got to get that vintage tweet from Sushi. Sushi, what do you got to say? I mean to say tweet.
Yeah, hey. No, I mean, I knew what you were saying. Listen, like I like to end every stream with a little bit of knowledge for the young guys, all right? Battle is the most magnificent competition in which a human being can indulge. It brings out all that is best. It removes all that is base. All men are afraid in battle. The coward is the one who lets his fear overcome his sense of duty. Duty is the essence of manhood. Y'all keep it fucking tight tonight, all right?